Okay, good evening everybody. My name is Zain. Today I'm going to present about gaining confidence in React app through testing. So the problems that I'm trying to solve is we as humans, we often make mistakes, and new features tend to introduce regression. So let's say we develop new features, sometimes we are afraid to change our code because it might be introduced regressions. And then since machines don't make mistakes, we might want to replace our human tester as a code. So that's how we have some tests in our code. So that's a new concept that at least it's new for me. Probably you have ever heard about it. So when we are developing our components, there are three types of users. First is the end user, the one that they are using our components. And then secondly, it's the developer, the one that is using rendering our components in their app. And then third is a test user, which is I'm going to explain. So here I'm going to present you two cases. The first one is false negative, which is a negative test result, but it's a false because it's actually true. It's actually correct. So in this case, we are trying to refactoring class component to function component. So it's a toggle function. And let's implement the toggle class component. So we have the state toggle as false, and then we have a handle function which just negates the toggle flag, and then we show if it's true then it's on, and then we have a button, if it's clicked then it triggers the toggle. Yeah, everybody can make this in 1 minute. So now let's test this using Zain. I think it's one of the most popular testing library out there. First, render the toggle using shallow rendering. It's I think it's the most popular rendering function in Zain. And then get the toggle state, assert the toggle state, the toggle state of the component that it is false when it's first time to be rendered. And then check whether it's actually rendering off, and trigger the handle toggle function which make the toggle state to be true and makes it rendering on text. Yeah, so this is the test. It's quite simple and it passed. So now let's say we want to move to React hooks because it's cool. And this is the component that I built using hooks. The way we build it is a little bit different. Here we have we call use state function with false as an initial value, and then we have a handle function to negate the toggle value, and then we display the on and off text based on the toggle value, and then we trigger the handler using the button. Yeah, so it's more concise, I think, but compared to the class, I think that's why people wants to use toggle wants to use hooks more than class. So when we swap those components, the end user feels okay with it, and the developer doesn't have to change anything other than changing the file from class to hooks. But then the test user complains about it, so it says it's a negative case, it's a failure, but it's actually a false negative. So yeah, that's how that's what the test user so this is another case where it introduces false positive detection. So in this case, we have a careless developer who made mistakes in button event propagation. So remember that button. So instead of So when they use the so the developer of the component, he forgot to add the handler to the button. So it's not fault at all. But the test user still passes. So go back again. So here, the only thing that it forgot is to passing the props to the on-click handler, but it still passed. Well, the end user will be frustrated because it's not actually working. So that's what happened. We have false negative and false positive. Now let's try testing it using React testing library, which is I think getting more popular in the recent year. So here we are using render function to test the to render the component, and then we get the text value. So this, so from the render component we get the off text, and then we expect it to be there, and then we expect the on text is not there, and then we get the toggle text, which is the text is inside the button, and we click that button. Okay. And then we assert that it shows on instead of off. So that's, and then at the end of the test we clean up the DOM so that the test is isolated. So this is roughly how it's worked. Then let's revisit our previous cases using this test. The first case is the false negative. After swapping the class components to function components, the end users feels okay, and the test still passes. And then for the false positive case, so this Keras developer will be complained by the test, and the test coherent with the end user experience. So in this case, this test user is aligned with what the end user experience. So what's happening here? Let's compare those two implementation, these two test implementation. The first one, so what does it even mean? We have shallow and we have render. So let's debug the rendering result. When we do it, that's what we got. So when we are shallow rendering, we are actually only render one component level under the that component. So if we are rendering a button, then it will only render it as a button text with this function. That's it. But when we are using render function from React testing library, it actually renders the whole component as in JS DOM. So it's actually rendering the actual DOM. And then the other difference is in Zain, we tend to access the inner state of the component, which is by default, it's not accessible from the from outside of the components. While in React testing library, we are, it's impossible to do that. So what we can do is, what we can do to assert the functions behavior, the components behavior is just, is by actually finding the text that is rendered. And then the third thing is, in Enzyme, it's also possible to get the function of the components instance, where again in React testing library, it's impossible to do that. So what we have to do is we have to find the text and we click the button containing the text. So can we do it using Enzyme? Yes, we can. So instead of using shallow, we should have been using mount. So if we use mount, we are likely not to have that experience. But then Enzyme's API is too powerful. So again, like what I said, it's possible to access the inner set of the component, which is not expected. That's why it's easy to make mistakes. While on the other side, React testing library's API is intentionally powerless. So what you can do in React testing library is you can only get the components from out. You can only get the out what the components return. So the key takeaway is so the more you test, the more your test assemble the way your software is used, the more confidence they can give you. Let's avoid testing implement details. So because testing implement details means it's more likely that we can have false positive or false negatives. This is not the concept of testing. So the one that I'm talking about is just unit and integration tests. So there are a lot of aspects of tests that we should explore. And that's all. I am inspired by Ken Sidos from his testing JavaScript course. And yeah, thank you for providing the stage.